années 2000, on sortait de la grande campagne du Jubilé qui incitait toutes les personnes à favoriser les pauvres, à aider les démunis, à libérer les peuples de leur esclavage. Alors, Développement et Paix, fidèle à son option pour les pauvres, les exclus, a décidé de mettre sur pied une grande campagne de 3 ans. Le monde n'est pas à vendre. Les 3 thèmes développés, les compagnies minières, les semences et l'eau.
The mining campaign was the first campaign that I ever got involved with Development and Peace. Having to move from your home or having your home, you know, your water poisoned and how that can potently affect you for things that are mined that we use here in the north just really got me to me emotionally, I think. It really made me understand the need for us to help because we're the ones that are contributing to these issues. We're the ones that are consuming these consumer goods that need to be mined.
East Timor was a former Portuguese colony. In 1974, when they were about to declare independence, the Indonesian military invaded. So Development and Peace played a role in their struggle for self-determination and independence. On May 20, 2002, East Timor became the first new country of the millennium. And I was there, invited to participate in the inauguration for the restoration of independence. On December 26, 2004, a gigantic tsunami hit 14 countries, India, Sri Lanka, Thailand, and of course, Indonesia, which is the nearest to the epicenter of the earthquake. We raised over close to $20 million for the recovery and reconstruction.
In 2005, 3300 maisons étaient reconstruites, les rues repavées. Et... Alors, c'est un projet où toute la population a été consultée, mise à partie.
And it was also the first time that Development and Peace was involved in supporting a, what we call people, community-driven reconstruction, where people are actually in charge of their recovery and reconstruction.